We've had toys released I never thought we would get a look at, and today I'll be having a squiz at the Transformers Earthrise Quintesson Judge. Welcome to Ted's Toys and Shenanigans, doing the reviews that no one views. Takaratomy released this egg-headed fellow on the 29th of August, and it was exclusive to Takaratomy Mall, along with the Alakom and Slitherfang. First of all, I would like to look at the box. It's exactly the same as a Hasbro release, except for these stickers, so it's not exactly the same. In fact, it is slightly different. It is a nice Voyager-sized box. I'd like to draw attention to this bit here. It would seem that the Quintessons have a faction logo now. The Alakon has the same one. Very beardy. Quintessons are something I thought we would have gotten sooner, as they seem pretty easy to design. And surely, most fans would have been fine with one that can't transform, right? Well, this guy is really quite nice. A small bit of assembly is required, but afterwards you have a nice five-faced egg toy. I'm sure all the kids are thrilled. Accessories-wise, you get an energy beam for floating on, a cute little gun for threatening people with. I was really pleased to see this gun. It sticks to one of his tentacles and flops around vaguely. Very nice. The tentacles are soft plastic and feel okay. They have a hinge at the shoulder, and while they can't be molded to your will, they can get a close approximation. You also get what every legless, floating, egg-shaped being needs. A chair throne? Or a bench is what I believe a judge sits on, or behind. As patronizing as I may appear, I really like this chair. It has a nub for plugging in the energy beam to secure the judge on it. You can also store the gun under the chair as well. How very underhanded. Character appropriate, I say. The bench also transforms. We'll check out that later. Sculpting is really good and the faces look really spot on. I've often wondered about the faces. Do they have different personalities? If we get three Quintesson judges together, do they all have the same faces? How do the jokes go? Three Quintessons walked into a bar, and the fourth one ducked. Do they all have the same personalities on the same faces? So many questions. You also get this cool flippy face gimmick thing, and it works pretty well. Considering how hard it is to tell where the front is, it's kind of a pointless addition. But it changes sharply enough to emulate the movie. Ambient sculpting on the rest of the egg robo looks pretty good too. They look different enough, aesthetic-wise, to other Transformers, which I welcome, because they're not really Transformers. On top of that, the judge transforms into a little base thing. You remove his scalp? Wow, is this guy the center console of the TARDIS? Remove his leg, flip up the faces. Flip down these panels. Remember to route this section to that. And plug that in there. Flatten the bench. Connect. Place the jail. Drop the dome on the top. And you're done. The cage is an obvious reference, but I'm not too sure what the judge's body is supposed to be. But that's cool, as it doesn't really look like a judge anymore. You can fit a little dude in the cage. The bench can join him to other Earthrise bases, and the gun can sit on the top of the cage. All up, this is a good, if simple, toy. The main gimmick is that it looks like a Quintesson, which it successfully pulls off. Nice, well done. The base mode interaction is a nice bonus that can be happily ignored if you want. But with all the other pieces coming out, I certainly won't be. It does make me wonder, if a fan has no attachment to the G1 Transformers, is this guy just as nice? Is he just as tempting? What do you think? Let me know. So in the end, I have passed judgment and reached a verdict. I declare his score to be guilty. Out of innocence.